The Cheeki Rafiki was a bento first 40.7, a 39-foot-long sailing yacht constructed in 2006 by French sailboat manufacturer Bento. The Rafiki was equipped with an 800-square-foot sail and a singular diesel engine in case the vessel lost sail power. The boat, originally purchased by a private customer in 2006, was purchased in 2011 by Stormforce Coaching, an England-based company that teaches sailboat training. In spring of 2014, after completing the Antigua Sailing Week event in the Caribbean, she headed back to Southampton, England. Before departure, Andrew Bridge, the Cheeki Rafiki's captain, and the director of Stormforce, Douglas Innes, discussed routing and weather reports for the forthcoming transatlantic voyage. During this discussion, they decided to attempt the crossing without stops. However, it was agreed the vessel would divert to the Azores for additional supplies if required. They also agreed that communications were to be limited to email, unless otherwise necessary. Leaving port on May 4th, the Cheeki Rafiki had a crew of four experienced sailors: Paul Gosselin, Steve Warren, James Mayle, and Andrew Bridge. The voyage across the Atlantic was supposed to take 30 days. Throughout the crossing, Andrew Bridge frequently emailed Douglas Innes using a satellite phone. Following are excerpts from the emails between Bridge and Innes during the journey. Monday, May 5th, 2014. 0800 hours. Email from Cheeki Rafiki. Quote, "Our position at 800 hours is 19 degrees, 0 minutes, 0.25 seconds north, by 61 degrees, 28 minutes, 32 seconds west. Got into a light patch. We now have a fifth crew member. A bird has been sat on the coach roof most of the night. Any weather routing info from you would be great, as you can see the bigger picture. Can you get ... to send instructions on changing the email to mail a sail?" 1700 hours. Response email from Stormforce Coaching. Quote, "You need to get some east and north in for the next 2 days. There is a band of southeast 4 coming in Tuesday afternoon to the east view. It fairly quickly settles to east 4. I think for the moment head northeast until you hit it, then head north by northeast, or even close to north. There is then a moderate breeze across the area you'll be sailing into for a couple of days. In the meantime, suffer the pain of the light stuff. I have requested the mail a sail password, but so far no reply. We'll provide all details once I have the password." Unquote. Tuesday, 6th of May, 2014. 1200 hours. Email from Cheeki Rafiki. "Position at 1200 hours is 21 degrees, 27 minutes north, by 60 degrees, 39 minutes west. Wind has been light and shite, heading north. Motored all of last night, so now we are able to sail. We have a range of 900 to 1,000 miles under engine if wind keeps dying. Azores looks highly likely. Any weather info from you would be great." 1300 hours. Email from Stormforce Coaching. Quote, "Go north. Do not pass go. Go north. Do not collect 200 pounds. Go north." Unquote. 2000 hours. Email from Cheeki Rafiki. Quote, "Heading north." Unquote. The email elaborates further about weather data, but I'll spare you those details. The next few days of emails show that the vessel continued northeast, occasionally running its engine when sails could not be used. Monday, May 12th, 2014. 1700 hours. Email from Cheeki Rafiki. Cheeki Rafiki blog update. "It has been 9 days at sea, and we are all faring well. The winds have been gentle, whilst rooting up northwards to the eastern side of Bermuda, and yesterday we did it. We turned east for home and completing our first 1,000 miles. We've had one stormy morning so far, with beating rain and a force 5 wind which lasted a few hours, but we are still enjoying plenty of sunshine and warm temperatures. Position update, 34 degrees 24 minutes north by 56 degrees 55 minutes west." 1000 hours. Email from Cheeki Rafiki. Quote, "Position update at 1000 hours, 37 degrees 0 minutes north by 52 degrees 5 minutes west. 24 hour run, 176 miles. Just hit a big wave hard, and it fixed the stereo." End quote. Thursday, May 15th, 2014. 2000 hours. Email from Cheeki Rafiki. Quote, "We've been taking on a lot of water yesterday and today. Today seems worse. I think starboard water tank has spilt, so that it has drained. Checked hull and sea cocks for damage, but can't see any. I will go for a swim when weather improves in about 24 hours. We are currently monitoring the situation. Warda is 900 miles away. Our position is 38 degrees, 38 minutes north, by 48 degrees, 59 minutes west. Any thoughts from your end? I will check emails in 2 hours. No further data connections were made on board Cheeki Rafiki. so no further emails were received by the vessel. The following emails never reached the crew. 2000 hours. Email from Storm Force Coaching. Quote, is any water fresh or salty? That will tell you most of what you need to know. End quote. Another email from 2000 hours. From Storm Force Coaching. Quote, loosen straps for life raft. Check EPIRB and SAT phone are accessible, etc. Have everything ready in case of worst case. End quote. 2200 hours. Andrew Bridge had a 55-second duration satellite telephone voice call to Douglas Innes, and a 2-minute, 46-second duration return call on a different mobile telephone, owing to low battery power. Bridge described the situation, that is, water ingress, as worse than before, and that the water had been identified as seawater. The engine bilge had been found to be dry, and that the leak could not be found. 2200 hours. Email from Storm Force Coaching. Quote, I need your position. End quote. 2200 hours. There is an attempted satellite telephone voice call from Douglas Innes to the Cheeki Rafiki. It was redirected to voicemail. Friday, 16th of May, 2014. 300 hours. There is a 1-minute, 42-second duration satellite telephone voice call from Andrew Bridge to Douglas Innes. Innes had difficulty understanding what Bridge was saying, but he understood him to be saying, quote, this is getting worse, end quote. Innes told Bridge to check his emails, which Bridge acknowledged. Cheeki Rafiki's approximate position at this time was 38 degrees, 37 minutes, 0 seconds north, by 48 degrees, 6 minutes, 7 seconds west. Thereafter, the satellite telephone was no longer connected to the satellite, and no further signal was received from it. After the phone call, Douglas Innes contacted Her Majesty's Coast Guard to alert them to the situation. The last known coordinates of the Cheeki Rafiki were within Boston Coast Guard's area of operation. RCC Boston scrambled an HC-130 long-range surveillance aircraft to the location of the crew's last recorded EPIRB signals. Upon arriving at the expected location of the vessel, the HC-130 was only able to spot debris in the water. At about 1400 hours, on 17th of May, 2014, the container ship Maersk Kerr located the upturned hull of a small boat, which was believed to be the Cheeki Rafiki. Adverse weather conditions prevented launching the ship's lifeboat or rescue boat to carry out a closer inspection. At 900 hours, on 18th of May, 2014, the United States Coast Guard terminated their search effort. RCC Boston had calculated the estimated survivability of the crew members based on their average descriptions, assuming that they were dressed in full foul-weather sailing gear, immersed to the neck in water, and wearing a personal flotation device. Using these criteria, the estimated functional survival time was 12 to 15 hours for each of the men. At 1100 hours, on the 20th of May, 2014, the search effort resumed following a formal request from the UK government. The second effort was again coordinated by RCC Boston, and the first search and rescue assets began to arrive later that day. During this period, aircraft from the USCG, US Air Force, Royal Canadian Air Force, and UK Royal Air Force were deployed, along with 9 merchant vessels, the United States Coast Guard cutter Vigorous, United States ship Oscar Austin, and numerous additional yachts. At 1500 hours on 23rd of May, 2014, USS Oscar Austin's embarked helicopter located an upturned yacht's hull. The vessel launched a small boat with a surface swimmer, who positively identified the hull as being that of Cheeki Rafiki. The swimmer also confirmed that its life raft was still on board in its usual stowage position. At 200 hours on 24th of May, 2014, the search and rescue effort was terminated. Following the incident, on December 5th, 2016, Storm Force Director Douglas Innes was charged with 4 counts of manslaughter by gross negligence. Innes pled not guilty, and was subsequently acquitted. Innes was, however, found guilty of failing to ensure the safety of the Cheeki Rafiki in the years prior. Following the guilty verdict, Storm Force Coaching went bankrupt and liquidated all of their assets. You can find more information about the firm's dissolution on their website, which I will link below. Most of the information in this video comes from the Marine Accident Investigation Branch's report on the loss of the yacht. That report will be linked below as well. Hands down, the sinking of the Cheeki Rafiki is an absolute tragedy. 4 young adventurous sailors' lives were cut painfully short in that fateful voyage. Before yesterday, I had never heard of the Cheeki Rafiki. Maybe it just wasn't as big of a news story here in the United States. That's why I made this video, to draw a little attention to a tragedy that I never heard of. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be making more content like this, so feel free to subscribe if you're interested in that. Thank you.